Please subscribe math.com for any query, comment or email. In today's lecture, we will see how you can find the square root of the decimals by division method if you are not allowed to use a factorization or any calculator, as factorization is for small numbers and by division you can get the large numbers. Let's see if you will be asked to find square root of 333.0625. So is it possible for you to find it just by looking at it, that like if you are given with under root 4, you will directly say it is 2, or you can find it by factorization method? So let's apply the division method on finding the square root of the decimals. Step 1 is make pairs of whole number part as 333.0625. The whole number part is this, and we have to make the pairs from right to left, okay? This and this. Okay. Step 2 is make pairs of decimal part as 333.0625. Here the decimal part is this, and you can make it pairs from left to right as like this. These are the two steps, and in step 3 just apply the division method on it. Let's apply it. The number was 333.0625 and the pairs were like this, this and this. These were the pairs. Now the steps we have to follow in division method are: In step 1, we have to find the divisor. The divisor must be equal to or less than the first digit or the pair from left to right. Here the digit is 3. We have to see this 3. Okay. So, if we take 1 and take its square, we will get 1. Okay. It is less than 3. Okay, let's check one more. If we take the square of 2, we will get 4, but it is greater than 3, but 1 is less than 3. So we will go with this option rather than this, and write here as 1, 1's are 1, with minus 3 minus 1 is 2, and we'll move these down, this pair 233. Okay. Then in the step 2, you have to double the quotient. Here the quotient is 1. This is the quotient. Okay. So we have to double the quotient, that is 1 plus 1. It will give you 2. Okay. So it is 2. Okay. It's 2. So we will write 2 here, and this space is blank. And we have to select a number that will give us either this 233 or less than 233. So let's find it out. If we write 22 into 2, we will get 44. No, it is too small. Then if we write 24 into 4, it will be 36. No, it is also small. If we write 5 into 5, it will give you 125. It is also small. Then 26 into 6 will give you 6, 3, 156. If we write 27 into 7, it will give you 189. Still it is small. 28, it will give you 224. So it is the nearest number that we can consider here. So 28 are 224. We'll subtract it, we'll get 9. And then we will move this pair down. It will be 906. Again, the next step is we have to double the quotient. In the step 3, double the quotient. What is the quotient? Quotient is 18 here. So 18 plus 18 will give you 36. We will write 36 here, 36 here, and the blank space. Now we have to select a number that will give us equal to 906 or less than 906. So if 36, when multiplied 3, 363, if we take 3 here, that the blank space, we will get 1089. It will be, if this number is greater than 906. So we will select 362. 362 are 724. We will get 1892. 2, and the last pair will move down, this pair 1, 8, 2, 2, 5. Now next step, we will again double the quotient. Quotient is 1, 8, 2. Okay, I'll write this here. Step 4, quotient is 1, 8, 2. We will double it as this and we will get 364. Okay, write 364 here and a blank space. Now we have to select a number that will give exactly as 1, 8, 2, 5. So by similarly, by checking the multiple numbers by multiplying them together, we can find out that 364, when 5 multiplied with this, we can get 1, 8, 2, 2, 5. This is all from the process, and this is a process in which you need a practice. If you get enough practice, then it will become easy for you to solve it quickly. Let's have one more example and we can solve it quickly. If you are given with 0.119025, how you can find its square root? Let's see. Again, the same method. We will make the pairs as from right to left, 1, 2, 3. Okay? Then we will not consider 0 here. So now we, in the step 1, we have to see that we have to consider a number that whose square must be less than 11. So if we say 2 into 2 is 4, 3 into 3 is 9, 4 into 4 is 16. So we have to select this rather than these two options. So we will write here 3 threes are 9. Okay, it will give us with 290. In the step 2, we will double the quotient. Okay, quotient is 3, then 3 plus 3 is equals to 6. Okay, then we'll write 6 here and a blank space, but it should be multiplied. Let's see. 61 into 1 is 61. 62 into 2 is 124. 63 into 3 is 189. 64 into 4 is 256. Okay, I think this is the nearest number that we can consider. So 64 fours are, we can take 64 fours are 256. So we will get 4, 3, and then these two will be moved down, will move down to 5. Okay, then in step 3, we have to again double the quotient. The quotient is 34 plus 34, we will get 68. Okay, then we will write 68 here, 68 and a blank space. Now we have to consider the number that will give us 3, 4, 2, 5. So let's see that by multiplying. So 685, if we multiply 685 by 5, then we'll get exactly the number equals to 3, 4, 2, 5. You have to analyze it, that what with which number you can multiply it directly rather than by checking each and every number, so that you can quickly go through the steps. 685, 5s are 3, 4, 2, 5. Okay, if this means that the square root of 0.119025 is equals to 3, 4, 5 with the point at the start. So 0.345 is the square root of this decimal number. So this was all about how you can find the square root of the decimal number by division method. Thank you for watching. If you like this video, please subscribe math.com.